Hi there, welcome. My name is Ferry Wolf, and within Tricentis, I'm a solution architect. And today I want to give you a demonstration on our virtualization solution, which is called Orchestrated Service Virtualization. But before I go into a demo, I first want to explain you the vision behind this one. As you can see in the current situation, there are a lot of stages and applications in scope. And let's assume we are responsible for application A. And in the complete development process, there are multiple applications surrounding that one. So in the development phase, we are starting with our own team to develop everything. And then after a few weeks or maybe a few months, there will be a first integration to test if things are going as expected. And then, of course, in the later stage, more and more the application will become stable. And of course, the testing will continue. And in the end, you have something in production. The thing here is that when you find something here in the end-to-end testing and you find a defect in the integration, then you have to go back directly to the development, which will result in a long development process. And that's where we want to support with OSV. So, there are three challenges where we can support. The first one is, of course, when a system is not available. So again, let's say we are responsible for application A, and this application has connections to the systems B, C, D, and E. And if those connections are not available, then we are blocking ourselves to continue testing. So we are depending on those third-party applications. By virtualization, we can simulate those surrounding systems, enabling us to test. A second challenge which we can solve is around test data. Let's assume that the integrations with system D and E is available, but we do not have access to that party because it's external. We do not have control of those environments. And we want to have specific test data from these environments into our system to be able to test certain situations. So again, we are depending on those parties. And by simulating, again, those interactions, we can also take care of the test data. And a third party, the third challenge which we can solve here is, of course, the costs. If you want to have complete environments available in all your stages, like development, test, acceptance, pre-production, and production, it is quite a costly thing. So by taking over simulation of certain interfaces, you can save money in your environments. So how does that then work? So in the development phase, again, we are depending on system A, we can just simulate and virtualize the surrounding systems, enabling us already to test our full application also with the interactions. And of course, our surrounding systems and teams, they are also developing. And at a certain moment, application B will become available. And of course, that's where you can already test the connection. And if the work is done correctly, those integrations should work fine. But of course, other systems can still be virtualized. Again, testing you the complete integration. And later on in the stage, of course, more and more applications will become stable. And in the end, you will have a stable production application directly in production. So what I'm going to show you in this case is the following use case. We again are team A, responsible for our website to test. And this website is using different applications here in the background via the services, a car service to check the data from a vehicle, the CRM service to get personal data or to write data into that service. We have some information back about the rating of this specific person. And in the end, when we're going to select a product, the result will be stored back into the order engine. And in this case, when one of those systems underneath is not available, it is blocking us to test our website. And that's where OSV comes into place. So OSV is also something we call the man in the middle. So here you will see OSV is in between. and when one of those systems is not available, then OSV will help out here in simulating the traffic. Here is a different view. So let's say Tosca or manual testers, they can also benefit from virtualization. They are still testing on system A, and during the process, there will be a request to the CRM service with a response. Again, a request to the rating service with a response, and a request and response back from the order service. And now OSV can be in between. It can capture and record all the actions and the traffic with those interfaces. And when those systems are not available, then of course OSV jumps in and will generate the response, enabling us to test. And also we can track all the messages and verify those messages. And maybe you're asking yourself, okay, it's good that we can record those messages, but what if a certain system is not available? B, C, D, or etc. They're not available. Then you cannot record. So in this case, from out of Tosca, we can also, based on a certain XML or definition language, we can generate our own stops in this way and push it to OSV. And that's something I will show you in the current demo. So here is our use case. As you can see here, we have a web front end, which is our vehicle insurance application. And in the back end of this application, there are services. So this is our internal demo environment. And to show you it's really front end, back end communication, I can show you a use case. So in this case, I will click on automobile. And there, if I select, for example, a certain make, a brand of a car, you will see a message will be sent to the car service and the information from the backend about the number of seats and the fuel type will be sent back. And as a tracing, you will see here in the log that an endpoint really has been hit. So here I will select, for example, Volkswagen. There we are. And there you can see the car service has been hit, Volkswagen. And here you'll see the number of available seats and the fuel types are available. To give you another solution or example, I can also fill in certain test data. So let's say I will fill in the first name and the last name. And when I now hit tab, you will see that our web page will hit the CRM service in the backend. The CRM service will find all the address details and will fill it in directly in our web page. And again, here you will see the log. So I will click on tab now. And there you'll see the endpoint of the CRM service has been hit and all the information has been available. So as you can see, it's really front-end, back-end communication. So if we now go back to the beginning, let me clear the log. Let's assume that a certain endpoint is not available. Let's say the CRM service is not available. And this is why it's an internal demo app. I can easily toggle this one off. So our backend service is now not available. So let's go back to our application. Let's directly go to the tab of the insurance data and let's fill in our person again. And you will see nothing happens. You will see there is an error message here. You will see there has been no log information. So in this case, we cannot continue with testing. We are depending now on the backend of the CRM service, depending on those guys blocking us to continue testing of our web page. And that's where OSV can help out. So therefore, in this case, for now, I will switch on the CRM service. And currently, I already have OSV running. So here, in the bottom of the page, you will see the so-called OSV monitor. That's where we can see everything what's happening in our central component, which will generate the stops. And here you can see I already have set up a certain environment. And if I open that one, you will see the configurations of the specific ports mapping our system on the test. This conversion is something you only need to do once. And now OSV knows where it needs to listen and capture all the traffic. And therefore we can do the recording. And when I click on recorder, of course, I can start the recording. And now OSV is listening to the traffic on those ports which I have configured, which I just showed you. So let's go back to our system on the test and let's start again the process of the automobile and directly let us go into the insurance data. Fill in our testing person. And there you will see endpoint has been hit and the information has been sent back. And in the meanwhile, if we will now go back to OSV, you'll see something has been captured. So let me click on stop. And there you will see there is a message in and a message out. So this was the XML message which has come in. So with Max Mustermann, as you can see here. And of course, when I double click on the out, you'll see the response back from our endpoint. And that's something that OSV has now captured. And from this recording, I can directly now create a stop. So therefore, I will click on the two rows, do a right mouse click and say, deploy the request and response pair as a scenario. I can give the logical name. And now we have a stop created from this recording. And the overview of available stops will be visible here in this tab available. And there you will see our stop for Max Mustermann is available. So let's test. We go back to our system on a test, refresh the page, get a log, and let's now again shut down the CRM service. And let's start our process again. We go to insurance data and fill in our person. And when I hit tab, you will see there is a response. But what you won't see here is any logging because our CRM service has been shut down. So there has not been any communication with the backend. It's now really OSV that has taken over and filled in all the values here in our frontend. And of course, this stops, you want to have those dynamic. In this case, it's only working for Max Mustermann, but we can also create this more dynamic. So therefore, you can use Tosca. And Tosca is an automation tool, which can do automated testing, but can also create data-driven tests. And this is how Tosca looks like. And I will not explain you now all the basics, but we can now push our recording back into Tosca and create some smart algorithms in there. For example, communication with a database. So here in our recording, I can also say, with a right mouse click, mark the messages for import. If I go to Tosca, you will see here a tab for OSV. And here with the option import. And import, of course, will import our recorded request and response pair. I will say yes. And there you will see there is a result. Here you'll see a folder with our OSV import with two folders behind. The first one you will see it's our get person operation with a request and the response steps. And these steps are also represented here in those two modules. Those are building blocks. And now we can easily create this one much more easier and also with a data-driven part. So therefore we can go to the request. Make it a bit more readable, like this. And of course, we want to have this easy to use. So the only information we are interested in is the first name and the last name. So I can mark these two. I will say add. And then you will see two variables has been. Also for the response. In this case, we want to have all the address details there. So we can just mark them and say add, and you will see here the business parameters will be created. If I will now go back to my OSV scenario, you will see in those steps, those fields are available. And now it's up to me. I can fill in any data which I want to have, where OSV should respond with. And of course, this information can also be taken over from a database. That's something I will show you in a minute. So let's say now I will fill in my own credentials. First name and the last name. So that will be, let's say, the request. And when this request comes in, this should be the response. Of course, I will fill in my same name, date of birth. Now let's take this one. I'll be a male, of course. I will be living in Testing Street. The country will be Netherlands. The zip code will be 12345. City will be Amsterdam. And occupation, I will be an employee. And now we are done. We just created our own stuff. And of course, we can also make this data-driven to create multiple stops in one go. So here we are ready, and now we can push back our created OSV scenario back onto the host. So therefore, in the OSV tab, I will say deploy. Maybe give the logical name. So this stop is about me. And when I say deploy, you will see here a few things happening, and now it has been pushed back to OSV. So if I go back to the monitor, I will go to the available scenarios. Besides Max Musterman, you will now also see my stop. So let's test this one also. So still, our backend service, the CRM service, is still down. And let's go for the automobile once more. And let me fill in my details. And there it is. With my information, with Testing Street in Amsterdam, I'm an employee, with all the information which I filled in without having any connection with the backend services. So in this way, I can easily influence also with my own test data. And this test data is something you can also grab out of a database, what I will show you now in a minute. So this is the use case what we're going to use to create a stops based on data from a database. In this case, again, we have our system on a test here in the right side. And in this case, our CRM service will not be available. And that's where, of course, we want to have OSV in between. But there it needs to fit in data which comes from another database, which we have in control, our database here in a CRM. So in this case, we will first query the database to get our personal data, the data on where the stops need to be created from. And that data will then, of course, be extracted and will be stored on our local drive. Based on that information, Tosca will then generate the stops based on that external data and push it to our OSV. So now when we execute the test cases on our front end, the whole process will work. But for the CRM part, OSV will jump in to give back the data which you have extracted from our database. And in the end, our application will bring back a unique contract number. That contract number will be stored, and of course, that's something we want to write back to our database to update our test set. So that's the use case, what I'm going to show you. So here you will see the scenario in Tosca. And there you will see I've created a few steps. The first one, of course, is create a database to get the data. And based on the data, the stops will be created. And then, of course, we're going to execute the test on our web page and write back the data into the database. And the first thing what we're going to do here is to query the database. So therefore, I've created a test case with a few steps. There, I'm going to create an Excel, get the data from the database, and of course, save this Excel document. And this Excel will then be used to generate those data. This document, Excel, will be stored here into the local drive. And this is how the database looks like. I've created an easy database for now. So where I have a customer table, and there you will see a few columns with my first name, my last name, and all kinds of contact details. And which is most of interest are the last two columns, used and contract number. So used is if I've already used this specific record. It will now be false, of course. And the last one is contract number. Our system on the test, in the end, will generate a contract number and will be written back into the database. So after the test case has been run, you will see used will be true and a contract number will be filled in with that specific data from our system on the test. So let's see how this works in Tosca. So therefore, I will now first execute this first step. And in just, well, a few seconds, it will have queried our database and will have generated our Excel document. And there you can see it's already done. And as a result, you will see here in our folder, there has now been created a Excel document with the extraction of the data. So this is something we can use for references later on. And now based on the data, we want to generate those stubs. And here, remember the black logo, these are the OSV scenarios. Again, with the request and the response of our person data. And here you will also see a small T over here. And this T means it is a template. It can use external data. And in this case, it has been connected to our Excel document. And based on that Excel document, Tosca will generate then one or more of those stubs based on the data from our database. So in this case, it will just generate one test case or one stub. But of course, if the database will give you multiple responses back, results back, then of course, Tosca will dynamically create multiple OSV stubs. So therefore, I will click on Instantiate. It will ask me which document. I will say yes. And here you will see that a new folder will be created there with, in this case, only one stub with my information from out of the database. So here you'll see my first name and last name, and here as the response will be all the data, the same as our database. And once again, if the query will have result back in multiple lines, automatically multiple OSV stubs will be created. And now just like in the beginning of the demo, I can deploy my scenario onto OSV. And there you will see it is now available. Then the next step is that we're going to execute our test case. And here you'll see it's a blue icon, which is the test case, and also we'll have, in this case, two steps. First, we're going to generate and execute the steps, and in the end, it will generate our ID, which will be saved, and that will then be written back into the database with the record we have. And also here, you will see that small t. Again, this is a template, because we can execute those steps with multiple data. Again, referencing to that same extract of data. So therefore, again, I will say instantiate. And in just 1 second, you will see a new folder also with the physical test case, which we can execute with the test data. And we can just execute the test case and I expect our stub will then also respond. So let's execute these steps and see the results back in the database. So there it clicks on automobile, fully automatic, fills in the data. There you will see the stub has responded. And there you see a unique contract number ending at 657 or something. And in the bottom of the page, you will see the test case is green. So based on the data from our database, the test case has been executed. And now let's go back to our database and let's refresh this view. There it is. So the status is now set to true, and there you'll see that contract number ending at 657. So this was the same number as our system on the test has generated and has sent back to us, and which we have now stored into database. So in this case, I hope I have shown you that we can have multiple steps where we can query the data, where we can generate the stub based on the data, execute the test case, and also write back the results. Thank you for your time, and if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to the email address you see underneath in this page. Thanks again, and enjoy your day. Bye-bye.